Welcome in the first course of the series, in which we explore the atomic model. My name is Stéphane Pomé, and I'll guide you through the chart of nuclides and explain where nuclear energy comes from. First, we make a quick tour through tiny parts of matter called molecules, atoms, and nuclei. Molecules are the smallest units of a substance that exhibit its chemical properties. They consist of atoms of the same or different elements, joined together by electrostatic forces and by sharing electrons through covalent bonds. The atom resembles a solar system. In the middle, there's a heavy nucleus with a positive charge, and orbiting around it are small electrons with a negative charge. In a complete atom, the sum of the charges is zero. The electrons are arranged in orbitals defined by quantum mechanics. The size of the nucleus is in the femtometer range, which is 10,000 times smaller than the atom. The nucleus contains positively charged protons and uncharged neutrons, which both consist of quarks. The nucleons are held together at close range by the strong force. A nuclide is defined by two numbers: the proton number, which tells us to which element the atom belongs, and the mass number, which is the sum of protons and neutrons inside the nucleus. For example, carbon-12 is a light nuclide consisting of 6 protons and 6 neutrons. Uranium-235 is a heavy nuclide with 90 protons and 145 neutrons. For the same element, one can have atoms with a different number of neutrons. We call them isotopes. They have a different mass, but chemically behave the same. For example, the lightest element, hydrogen, has isotopes with 1 or 2 extra neutrons. They are called deuterium and tritium. Now that we know the structure of the atom, we can explore the chart of nuclides. In chemistry, we have the periodic table of elements, which is arranged according to nuclear charge number, and the groupings reflect the filling of electron shells around the nucleus. In a nuclide chart, all nuclides are plotted as a function of their number of protons and neutrons. There are roughly 3,000 nuclides, but most are unstable. Only the black dots in the chart represent stable nuclides. Stability is higher around magical numbers corresponding to full nuclear shells. Here we see a detail. The isotopes of one element are arranged in horizontal lines. The isotones are in one column, and the isobars on a diagonal. The stable nuclides are indicated in black, and the radioactive ones have a color code. Nuclear scientists often navigate through the nuclide chart to see how one nuclide transforms into another through radioactive decay. For example, beta minus decay corresponds to a jump from the purple square to the orange. The same is done for nuclear reactions. This is handy for deciding how to produce a nuclide in the laboratory, but also to understand how nuclides are transformed in the reactors or stars. By the way, do you know where atoms come from? Well, only the lightest elements were produced after the Big Bang. The others have been synthesized by nuclear reactions in stars. And it takes really large stars and supernovae to produce the heaviest elements. Now you know, we are made of stardust. Last but not least, let's see where nuclear energy comes from. It has to do with Einstein's formula relating mass with energy. First, we define a unit of mass for the atom, which is 1/12th of the mass of a carbon-12 atom. This is roughly the mass of one neutron or one proton. A deuterium atom has a mass of about 2 atomic mass units because it has one neutron and one proton. The mass of an electron is 2,000 times smaller. However, the funny thing is that the sum of the individual masses of these three particles is higher than the mass of deuterium. So where is the missing mass? Well, here it is. The missing mass corresponds to the binding energy. The binding energy is the energy needed to pull each particle apart from the nucleus. Einstein's formula makes the link between the binding mass and the mass defect. The binding energy per nucleon is not the same in each nuclide. The most tightly bound nuclides have an intermediate size, like iron. The least tightly bound nuclides, or light elements, like hydrogen, and the very heavy ones, like uranium. That means that binding energy can be gained through fusion of hydrogen or fission of uranium. This is fusion. By smashing deuterium and tritium atoms together, one makes a more stable helium atom and a neutron. The sum of their mass is lower because of the higher binding energy, and the mass defect is released as fusion energy. When a big uranium nucleus splits into two fragments and some neutrons, a lot of mass is converted into kinetic energy. This creates heat, which can be transformed into electricity. Thank you for watching this video. I let you reflect on it all with a picture of the remains of a supernova, the birthplace of our heavy elements. We are all stardust. Isn't it romantic?